Here's a pretty amazing scene. We are inside of a submersible. Now, I'll stress, not the kind of submersible that could go to the depth of, say, where they believe the airliner is, but it's a perfect way to demonstrate some of the challenges as well as the abilities. If you take a look back here, let me just demonstrate how extremely tight these quarters are. Our pilot has to sit all the way directly behind us here in the dark, and he is the man in control. He's guiding this vessel. Meanwhile, the two of us up here, Phil Newton, who is the expert on underwater recovery work, has been doing this for decades, is going to show us how manipulating this arm at this depth of retrieving a black box. It's one we set out there, but it's a way to give you a good example of just how, even in this murk, that you can begin to evaluate the tricky circumstances. So, Phil, if you would, we've already grasped it with the mechanical arm that you've got here, right?
So I'm going to now try to swing it over and get it in the basket, which is not as easy as one might suppose.
And so there you can see the black box has got to be retrieved by the claw. It's no easy thing just finding it in the gloom. But then the next step is it's got to get into the basket, because that is the way it's going to be transported to the surface. And again, we point out to you at this depth, it would be totally dark. We're using very bright lighting out there, but even then you can see the gloom. On top of that, manipulating this arm is not as easy as using your own hand to try to grasp something under the water. So positioning it carefully, you've got to get it in. You've only got a few tries at this, and remember, the amount of time you can spend at this depth is limited. Just coming it in, at the same time you've got to coordinate with the pilot to make sure you keep the vessel in position. But there it is.
Now
retrieve
we'll
the flight data recorder, we'll hold it there, and take it to the surface. And that's the way it's done. Martin-Savidge, Horseshoe Bay, British Columbia.